Hello, in this video we take a closer look at VLC Media Player, one of the most popular video playback programs. This free and open source software can run almost any video and audio format without issues. It works smoothly across all desktop and mobile operating systems, including Windows, macOS, Linux, Android, and iOS. VLC isn't just for playing media files, it also offers advanced features like converting videos to different formats and finding online subtitles with a single click. Downloading VLC Media Player is quite simple. All you need to do is visit its official website at videoland.org. Once you're on the site, your operating system is automatically detected, and you can directly download the appropriate version for Windows, macOS, or Linux using the download button on the homepage. For mobile users, links to Google Play and the App Store are provided, making it easy to install the safe and up-to-date version of VLC on your Android or iOS device. Installing VLC Media Player is very straightforward and doesn't require any additional configuration. When the setup wizard opens, simply follow the on-screen instructions and click the Next button at each step. The installation is completed in just a few steps, and the program is successfully installed on your computer without any issues. After installing VLC Media Player on your macOS or Windows device, your video files might not open with VLC by default. To change this easily, right-click on a video file you want to play. Windows users should select Properties, while macOS users should click Get Info. In the window that appears, click Change and select VLC Media Player from the list. Then click Apply on Windows or Change All on macOS to set VLC as the default player for all files of that type. This way you won't need to choose a program every time you open a video. The interface of VLC Media Player is clean, straightforward, and entirely focused on functionality. When you open the program, you'll see menu options at the top such as Media, Playback, Audio, Video, Subtitles, Tools, and View. Through these menus, you can open media files, adjust audio and video settings, add subtitles, or customize the appearance of the player to suit your preferences. At the bottom of the screen, you'll find essential playback controls for everyday use, such as play pause, fast forward rewind, volume adjustment, full screen mode, and a timeline slider that lets you navigate through the video with ease. One of the standout features of VLC Media Player is the VL Sub extension, which allows you to automatically find and add subtitles that match the video you're watching. This tool uses the opensubtitles.org database to search for subtitles based on the video's title or content. To use VL Sub, first click on the View menu at the top, then select VL Sub to launch the tool. In the window that appears, choose the subtitle language you want and enter the title of the video. If you're watching a TV series, you can get more accurate results by adding the season and episode numbers. Alternatively, you can search using the hash method. A hash is a unique digital fingerprint of a video file. Videos with identical content share the same hash, even if their file names are different. This method is especially useful when you don't know the exact name of the video. After the subtitle search, choose the most suitable option from the list and click the Download Selection button to open the download link. Download the .srt file, and to enable automatic subtitle recognition, make sure its name matches your video file, for example video.mp4 and video.srt. When you enable the Advanced Controls option from the View menu in VLC Media Player, four additional buttons appear above the playback controls. The record button starts recording the video from that moment and stops when clicked again, making it very effective for quickly trimming a specific part of the video. Recordings are typically saved to the videos folder. However, note that you cannot fast forward the video while recording. You need to watch the section you want to trim in real time, which is suitable for short clips but can be tedious for longer videos. The Take a Snapshot button captures a still frame from the video and saves it as a PNG file in the Pictures folder. The Loop from A to B button continuously repeats the section between two marked points, A and B. Clicking a third time stops the loop. The Frame by Frame button allows you to move forward one frame at a time after pausing the video, making it ideal for detailed analysis. Converting video or audio files to different formats with VLC Media Player is quick and easy. To begin, click on the Media tab in the top menu and select Convert Save. A new window will open with four tabs. The File tab lets you add media files from your computer. The Disk tab is for opening or converting content from physical media like DVDs, CDs, VCDs, or Blu-ray discs. The Network tab allows you to convert live streams or media links from the internet or your local network. The Capture Device tab is used to record or convert input from live sources such as a webcam, TV tuner, or screen capture. To convert a video or audio file in VLC Media Player, first click the Add button under the File tab to select the file you want to convert. You can also add multiple files. After adding the files, click the Convert button. In the window that opens, the selected file will be listed under the Source section. Then choose the desired format from the Profile menu in the Settings section. There are many formats available for conversion. For video files, common options include MP4, AVI, MKV, MOV, FLV, TS, and 3GP. For audio files, you can choose from MP3, WAV, FLAC, OGG, AAC, and more. Additionally, you can convert video files to specific resolutions or codecs, making it easy to convert files into formats compatible with different media devices and platforms. For example, converting a video from MP4 to TS format can be useful when you need to change a video file into a TV program recording. In this example, I'll convert an MP4 file to TS format. After selecting the format, set the destination folder and file name under the Destination section, then click Start to begin the conversion. Depending on the length and format of the file, the process may take a few seconds or several minutes. Once completed, the converted file will be ready for use at the specified location. Thank you for watching.